Wow. So today we are on the upper portion of the Pocomoke River. We put in at Porters Crossing. It's a great paddling trip. The crew at the Pocomoke River Canoe Company can help you out. But anyway, we're paddling 5.5 miles from Porters Crossing north of historic Snow Hill all the way back to town to the canoe shop. So along the way, we're going to be looking for prothonotary warblers and turtles and lizards and any number of birds, eagles. So it's going to be a great trip. So come along. So out here today, we have had an amazing time. Probably the first impressive bird we saw was the bright yellow gold male prothonotary warbler. This is a little songbird that arrived here in April and is nesting here in the swamp. One of North America's only two North American cavity nesting birds. So it nests in little tree cavities over the water and is totally evolved for life in a swamp. So we had a lucky break today that one of our friends on this trip happened to catch a glimpse of a shadow fly over the river. And when she looked and saw where it landed, she found a barred owl, B-A-R-R-E-D. This is our swamp owl. This is another bird that really just loves wet woods and can be pretty active in the daytime. They certainly are a lot more active at night, but we got a wonderful look at this very large owl on a branch. So on this stretch of the Pocomoke River between Porter's Crossing and Snow Hill, there is an active bald eagle nest. We first heard the parents kind of making a little racket, making a little noise, warning us that they were nearby. But when we got up onto the nest, we looked up and saw one large dark brown baby eagle, not a tiny fluffy baby now, but maybe a halfway to fledging age eagle, a big brown bird that should be taking flight here a little bit into the summer. And one of the parents hanging out. So that was a real treat to see an active bald eagle nest on the Pocomoke River today. So when we bird and paddle on the Pocomoke, especially in May, we're looking for songbirds. We're looking for warblers and vireos and tanagers. And a bird we heard first today, but then got a really good look at, was one we don't often see on the river, and that's the yellow-billed cuckoo. This is a very large songbird that popped out on the side of the river and then kind of flew with us as we paddled towards Snow Hill. So we had a really good look at that bird too. So almost any day on this river, especially on a nice sunny day in May, if you look on the sides at the logs that are kind of washed up and floating, you're going to see basking turtles. Today we've mostly seen eastern painted turtles. That is probably our most common freshwater turtle. They get cool swimming in the morning in the water, and they want to come out. They're a cold-blooded reptile, so they have to crawl up on a log and get some sun to warm up in the afternoon. So we've seen lots of red-bellied turtles and a few red-bellied turtles today. So one thing we found today on this trip was an beaver lodge. It looked like a big pile of sticks at the bottom of a little tree island on the side of the river. But upon closer examination, you can see some order to the sticks. And if you look at the ends, they've been nibbled on by large beaver incisors. So we didn't see a beaver, but we did get to paddle by a beaver lodge. So we're here at the dock at the Pocomoke River Canoe Company. We've had an absolutely fantastic afternoon in the river. I mean, you guys have to get out here this summer. So my buddy Scott Housen's with us, one of our bird guides in the area. Scott, highlights for you out in the river today.
Oh my gosh, it was an amazing day. We had prothonotary warblers. Not one, not two, dozens and dozens and dozens of prothonotary warblers. Acadian flycatchers, American red start, northern perula. We had a blue grosbeak and great crested flycatchers as well. But to top it all off, one of our guests found a very cooperative, very close barred owl in the middle of the day, and it was amazing. Now, yesterday, I got my second COVID vaccine, and the last thing I wanted to do was paddle 5 miles on a kayak, but that barred owl and those prothonotary warblers made every second and every stroke worthwhile.
So there you go, folks. Get your second shot and come down and kayak and canoe Porter's Crossing to Snow Hill, the Naswango Creek, but get here now when the birds are all nesting and you won't be disappointed. Scott and Bud, thanks, man. All right. So we really hope you'll come down to Snow Hill, Maryland, here along Maryland's coast, rent a canoe, rent a kayak, bring your own, but get out here on the water on the Pocomoke River, Naswango Creek, when you're traveling Maryland's beach and beyond.